Well, here we are back again, and it's been a while, hasn't it, people? It's about 3 weeks or so since we made a little commentary clip. Yes, we've been very well. I've been busy. I've been setting exam papers. What's that, Angela? Learning? You wanted to know what the format's going to be like. It's going to be like the format in previous years. In fact, there's a couple of past exam papers up there, and I've recently put up the solutions to the 2005 exam, part 5. But as you know, the law in this course changes, and in fact I've been putting up some new news items in the announcements about changes to family law and changes to social security law which are coming in. And if they're topics we look at in this course. You're behaving yourself there, pencil dog, with Robo Murine. This is Robo Murine here. I heard you were famous Robo lawyer. You made it into the primary schools. People are talking about Robo lawyer in the primary schools. Anyway, right, we've done 3 more weeks of topics in this course. First one was sources of law. That's where law came from. So. And then the following week we did the doctrine of precedent and the common law and how that works. And this week we finished off by looking at statutes and legislation. So it's all quite interesting, and they do tie in together because, in fact, the doctrine of precedent and the statutes follow on with some of the ideas which we talked about in the second week. Yes, there was a lot of material in the second week to go through, wasn't there? Because we talked about the Australian Constitution and the differences between the Commonwealth Parliament and the State Parliaments and things like the division of powers, so that we know Commonwealth Parliament has power to make laws in certain areas and states have powers to make laws in other areas, and sometimes they have laws in both. Yes, and we talked about the doctrine of terra nullius, the idea of the empty land. So when the English people came out in 1788, they took the view that terra nullius applied because the indigenous population did not seem to have an existing system of law, and they just didn't know how to classify it and deal with it. Yes, that's been addressed to some extent, I guess, as time gone by, and that was the famous case. What case? Yes, Mabo's case. That happened way back in the 1990s now. So, what's that, Robo Lawyer? Why do you have to know about the parliaments and things like that? Well, I guess that's useful because it gives you an idea of where the laws are coming from, and how laws are made, particularly the statute law. And this week we talked about how statute was made and how it goes to the Houses of Parliament and gets voted on, and sometimes it gets amended and changed, and then eventually it's passed and comes into force as a law. Yes, and this statutes come into force at different times depending on whether there's been a date set or whatever. And what's that, Angel Learning? You liked a bit about how to interpret statutes because, yes, it gets quite interesting, doesn't it? Because sometimes words in a statute are ambiguous. That means they might have a number of different meanings. And because it's going to affect the people's rights, we've got to be very careful about getting the meanings right. In fact, there were some common law rules which courts used to use, and like, what's that? Okay, we'll go around. Robo Murine, what's one of them? You say what? The golden rule. You picked the golden rule. Pencil dog, what did you pick? The mischief rule. Well, why would pencil dog pick the mischief rule? Yes. Okay, and Angel of Learning, what's that? The literal rule, what it says is what you get, yes. Robo, now there's another approach which has come in, very popular now, that's the purpose approach. So when we're trying to work out how a court may interpret a statute, we also learnt another word for interpret, it begins with C. Can anyone remember that? What's that, robo lawyer? Contrive, no, not quite right, robo lawyer. What? No one can remember it. What about you, pencil doc? Yeah. It's construe, and construction means how an interpretation. So that was one thing we learned. And when you're talking about that, you need to know that you put forward the arguments. You don't have to look for a trick. We looked at some of the exercises in the textbook on that chapter. And the last area we talked about was the doctrine of precedent and those law reports. And in fact, I've got some law reports sitting there, and I'm going to lift up your jabber, robo lawyer. And robo lawyer is actually sitting on some other law reports there. That's so you can people can see you more clearly. Yes, but these days the law reports in electronic format, so that's a lot easier. That's right. Part of our assignment is looking at a law report and trying to answer the questions on it. Yes, most of it's fairly straightforward, yes. And what's that? I put some sample answers up from previous years up in the assessment section of the course webpage today. Yes, I did, to help people so they know, they can go and look at that as well. So, and all the Latin terms. Oh yes, that's right. We did a lot of Latin terms, didn't we? We learned about what the ratio dissidendi, and that doesn't show very clearly. You have to work it out, so it's very hard to find. And different people will argue that different court cases have, or the same court case. That's the same court case can have different. Ratios dissidendi, rationales, R-A-T-I-O-N-E-S. That's how we spell it out, I think. Now, that's how it is at the moment. You won't move over here, Angela Learning. Yes, you can be seen. There's Angela Learning. You've got to be held up too. Robo Marine wants to be held up too, because we don't have very sophisticated cameras here. Okay, so here we go. Yeah, so that's the obiter dictum, and then there's a justum generis, that's a presumption, that's a starting point in interpreting words. Nociter, yes, we've learned. Terra nullius, yes, we've learned all these Latin expressions. Do we have to know them for the exam? Well, they'll probably be on the exam paper, but it's an open book exam, so you can always look them up. But what's that? You've been marking in your books where things are for the exam. That's a very good approach. It's very smart. It's very sensible. So what are we going to do now? Maybe if people want other questions, perhaps they can start sending you in questions, Robo Lawyer, and we'll talk about them as well, because if you want to see more Robo Lawyer, you can look for them in the earlier commentaries from earlier years, and all the Robo Lawyers are up on YouTube as well, aren't they? They're up on YouTube, so you can go back and see what we're talking about statutory interpretation, doctrine of precedent from previous years as well. Yes. Well, we might say goodbye now. You say goodbye, Angela Learning. Goodbye, Pencil Dog. There's Pencil Dog here. There's Pencil Dog. He's moved over here. Robo Marine. And we say goodbye, Robo Lawyer. I think we've covered it all. Yes, people have been writing a lot on the discussion board, and I've been trying to answer it. Have I set the exam? Yes, I've set the exam. I think students will be able to cope with it, Robo Lawyer. Yes, it will deal with aspects of the latest law, so Yes, it's very wise to practice to pass the exams. Now, I'm really, you're just trying to hang on and hang on, aren't you, here? You're just trying to hang on. Like, okay, I think that's it. We'll leave it there now, and because all the pencil dog, you leave Rubber Murine alone. He's chasing, you're so bad, you're chasing Rubber Murine. I'm going to just...